Good morning, everyone. It's your English class, and today we are going to study our next chapter, that is birds and Salim Ali. So let's start. First of all, let's warm up. Can you identify these common birds of India? Match the names of the birds with their pictures. So dear students, some pictures or birds are there, you need to identify with their names. So some names are also written. First name is that, as you can read here, house sparrow, Indian robin, common mynna, Indian roller, Alexandrine parakeet. These names are written here. So can you identify who's like these, our means, what are the names of these birds? So see that first picture, that is Alexandrine parakeet. Second picture, common mynna. Third picture, that is Indian robin. Fourth picture, that is this one, that's the Indian roller. Fifth picture, that is house sparrow. So these are the birds of India. B part, name these people. So some people names you need to identify. First is that a person who studies plants. So how we call them? Those are called botanist. A person who studies about plants, those are called botanist. B-O-T-A-N-I-S-T, botanist. Next is a person who studies animals, that is called zoologist. Third is a person who studies birds, so that is called ornithologist. Fourth is a person who studies insects, that is called entomologist. And fifth, a person who studies men, that is called sociologist. So these are the person who study regarding plants, animal, birds, insects, and men. Now please come on the next page. So dear students, in this chapter we are going to study about a great person, that was the entomologist, means that was the a person who did the study, scientific study regarding the birds. His name was Salim Ali. So Salim Ali, regarding Salim Ali, we are going to study in this chapter. So let's start. Ornithologist, unlike bird watchers, make a scientific study of birds. Sotha says in this line that ornithologist, a person who is not like the bird watchers, and he does the scientific study of birds. Bird watchers are as evident by name are hobbyists who watch birds in their natural environment and learn to identify them. In order to correctly identify birds and to settle any arguments that might arise from the identification, most bird watchers refer to handy guides by India's foremost authority on the subject, the ornithologist Dr. Salim Moizuddin Abdul Ali. So this was the name of full name of that person, Dr. Salim Moizuddin Abdul Ali. In short, we say it Salim, Dr. Salim also we say. So he did the special study regarding the insects. So whenever bird watchers, there is a need of any type of guidance, so they take the book written by Dr. Salim Moizuddin Abdul Ali. So he was the foremost authority regarding this subject. Right? Next line. Salim Ali, born in 1896, was the youngest of the brood of 9 children. So Salim Ali, birth date was 1896, and he was having eight sibling. His parents passed away when he was still a child, and he and his siblings were brought up by his uncle Amiruddin Tyabji. So author says about Salim Ali. So when he was very young child, so his parents passed away, means died, and his uncle was there. His name was Amiruddin Tyabji. So he did the caretake of the slain. Next line. Amiruddin Tyabji used to accompany men of royal families in their shikars, means hunts. Conservation was not a concern back then, being a good marksman who could boast of a good back for something to be proud of. Salim Ali, all of 9 or 10 years old, was gifted an air gun by his uncle. So in these lines, author says that his uncle name was Amiruddin Tyabji, and he used to help the royal people, the royal family, basically for shikar or like hunts. That time, conservation means like to save the wild animals was not concerned back. As we concern in present scenario, that was not concerned back. So he used to help them. So one day, what happened when Salim Ali was just 9 or 10 years old? So he was gifted an air gun. Air gun means like small gun, which is not the real gun. Sorry, the air gun. It was given by his uncle. Right. Next line. It was not a very reliable weapon, but the young boy began to hunt house sparrows with it. One such dead sparrow had a faint yellow spot on its throat like a curry stain. He took it to his uncle, who, not being able to identify it, and sent young Slim to, next part, Bombay Natural History Society. So one day, what happened? He got the air gun. So by this, Slim started doing the hunting, and he killed a sparrow, and that sparrow was having the stain of like yellow color, means like stain of curry stain. He was not able to identify this, and he went to his uncle and he said to his uncle, please tell me about this sparrow. So his uncle sent him in the BNHS. BNHS means Bombay Natural History Society. Next line. There the young boy not only found out that the dead bird was a yellow-throated sparrow, but was also shown other stuffed specimens. Salim Ali returned home with a fascination for birds and 2 books to get him started. Common Birds of Bombay and a Naturalist on the Prowl. So in these lines, author says that Salim Ali was sent in the BNHS to get the identification of that home sparrow, dead sparrow. So he got the information there, that is yellow-throated sparrow. It was the name of that sparrow. And he saw all specimen also of the sparrows, and he got the interest there regarding the birds, right? And regarding the birds, he got 2 books from there. Books names are written here, Common Birds of Bombay and a Naturalist on the Prowl. So these 2 books he got from there. Next line. While still in school, Salim Ali wanted to take up zoology, particularly ornithology, and become an intrepid explorer and a big game hunter. However, he found the first year of college so difficult that after struggling through it for 8 hard months, he gave up. So when he was about 18, He went up to Burma in order to help his brother run a hardware shop there. So what happened? Author says in these lines, he became quite interested, means Salim Ali became quite interested regarding the birds. So he thought that I will do my study regarding the zoology, especially ornithology. And he took the admission. He wanted to be an intrepid explorer, means brave explorer, and a big game hunter. Big game hunter means such a person who can hunt big animals. So he wanted to be, but as he joined the college for doing the study, he found that it is very difficult. So he left that study and went to Burma to help his brother. And his brother was having a business of hardware business. He was having that. So he went to Burma. Right? Next line. So when he was about 18, he went off to Burma in order to help his brother run a hardware shop there. This thing I have told you. Next line. Weekends found him making a study of the birds found in Burma. In the year that followed, their business expanded to include the use of timber. This gave him an excuse to explore the jungles of Burma for timber as well as for the large game and birds. So in these lines, author says that he went to Burma to help his brother regarding his business. Business was of that's hardware business was there. So for the hardware business, he had to go in the jungles of Burma, and there he got chance to explore the jungles of Burma. And he did the study. He did some exploration regarding the birds in the jungle of Burma, right? Because he had to get the wood from there for his business. Next line. At 22, he married Tahimana, a woman sportive of his passion for birds. Together, they raised Burmese silver pheasant from wild collected eggs and had a leopard cat and a tree shrew and a flying lemur and a great pied hornbill as pets. The author says in these lines, he got married to a girl. His name was Tahimina. Tahimina was her name. And she was also passionate regarding this interest, means regarding the birds. So from Burma, they got the Burmese silver pheasants. And from these, they got from the wild collected eggs. And leopard cat also, tree shrew also, and flying lemur also. Lemur is type of monkey, and a great pied hornbill as pets. So they go from there, from that jungle. Right, next line. The hardware business ran into a loss, and the couple returned to Mumbai, now Mumbai. So author says in these lines, like their business started getting loss. So they left the Burma and they went to Mumbai. Now that is Mumbai. Next line, Salim Ali tried to land jobs as an ornithologist, but the lack of a college degree prevented him from being selected. Finally, the BNHS convinced the then government to create the post of a guide lecturer in the natural history section of the Prince of Wales World Museum. So what happened after coming from the Burma? He wanted to get a job as an ornithologist, but he was not having any type of degree from any college. So that's why he did not get the job. So he requested BNHS to create a job. Job name was that, post name was that, guide lecturer. So they provide the job to him. Salim Ali filled in the passion. While he held the job for 2 years, he also realized that his real interest was not in birds. So he was in birds, and he decided to enroll in a proper study over ornithology. So in these line, author says that he spent 2 years there and he did the job, but he felt that, means Salim Ali felt that his real interest is in the birds, not in doing in the, like doing this job. So he left that job. Next page. But as he put it in his autobiography, ornithology has always been the Cinderella of Indian zoology. And there was no university or institution in the country where such training could be had. So Salim Ali went to Berlin University Zoological Museum instead. He stayed there for a year, trained under experts and learned the techniques and procedures of taxonomic work and also ringing techniques. The author says in these lines, Salim Ali wanted to do his further study. He wanted to pursue his passion regarding the birds. So he thought that I will do the like particular course regarding the ornithology. So that time in India, there was no university where he could do such type of course. So he went to Berlin University of Zoological Museum. And he stayed for a year, means for 1 year he stayed there and got the training course. And he learned many techniques regarding the taxonomic. Taxonomic means making the types of birds. And ringing techniques. Ringing techniques means like put the ringing in the feet of the birds. Okay, so he did many types of training there. Next line. However, even his training in Germany did not assure him a job when he returned. Finally, he came up with an ingenious idea. He offered the BNHS that he would carry out systematic field survey of the bird life found in Indian subcontinent on a voluntary basis, provided they raised the necessary funds to cover the actual working travel accommodation expenses. So in these line, author says that he got the training from Germany, but this training did not help him to get the job. So he got a very good idea. In this, he offered that to BNHS that I will do the systematic survey regarding the birds. But condition is that person, that society will have to give the expenditure. So next line. Wait, please. Let me take your attendance. Then you will start. Please stay connected. Next line. The BNHS accepted and the first survey began in Hyderabad. So BNHS accepted this matter, this offer, and first survey was done in the Hyderabad. Next line. In his search for the specimens in the initial days, Salim Ali had to try out different methods to capture the variety of birds found in subcontinent. So in the like initial days when he started doing such type of training, so he used number of techniques to catch or capture the variety of birds. Next line. In the survey team used mist nets like a nets like we use in the volleyball. So these type of nets were used there. These were set up during the early hours of dawn or dusk or during the night to capture unsuspecting birds. This ensured that the shy and sulking birds of dense shrubby were also identified and categorized. So what happened? They started putting the net, that moist net, in like just before the end of just before the end of the day or just starting the day, means in the morning time or evening time, so that they can cap unsuspecting birds. Usually those birds which don't come in the scenario, don't come in the daytime, so they like put the mist net to catch them. Next line. Salim Ali chose to begin his work in remote areas. Remote areas means far away areas. They carried specimen boxes, hurricanes, lanterns, iron buckets, bedding, towels, sheets, bags of rice and flour, crockery, cutlery, ghee, kerosene tins, and dome-shaped open work bamboo basket of live chickens for progressive transfer to the menu. So whenever, like in this line, author says that whenever they did the training regarding the birds catching, so they used to bring such type of material so that they can survive, right? So dear students, some difficult words are written here. Let's understand them. Then we'll go on the next page. So first word is marksman, a skilled, accurate shooter, means a person who can shoot nicely, accurately. यानी कि कैसा पर्सन जो शूटर, अच्छा शूटर. बैग, बैग मीन्स हियर ऑल द बर्ड्स एनिमल्स शॉट ऑन द वन ओकेजन, यानी कि ऐसे बर्ड्स एनिमल्स जो किसी एक ओकेजन पर पकड़े जाते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड बैग. नेक्स्ट इज फैसिनेशन. फैसिनेशन मीन्स अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग अट्रैक्शन दैट मेक्स समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, यानी किसी को लुभा लेना किसी चीज के रिगार्डिंग. टैक्सोनॉमिक. टैक्सोनॉमिक मीन्स पर्टेनिंग टू साइंटिफिक प्रोसेस ऑफ क्लासिफाइंग थिंग्स, यानी कि क्लासिफाई करना, चीजों को वर्गीकरण करना, उसको बांटना, उसके टाइप्स बनाना. नेक्स्ट इज रिंगिंग. रिंगिंग मीन्स हेयर पुटिंग अ रिंग अराउंड द लेग ऑफ बर्ड्स टू एनेबल इंडिविजुअल आइडेंटिफिकेशन, यानी कि बर्ड्स की जो लेग होती हैं उनके अंदर कोई रिंग डाल देना ताकि उनकी अलग से आइडेंटिफिकेशन बनाना, दैट इज कॉल्ड रिंगिंग. नेक्स्ट मिस्ट नेट. मिस्ट नेट मीन्स अ नेट यूज्ड टू ऑर्निथोलॉजिस्ट टू कैच बर्ड्स, टिपिकली मेड ऑफ नायलॉन और पॉलिएस्टर मैश, यानी कि एक ऐसे तरह का नेट जो पोलिस्टर से बना हो, नायलॉन से बना हो, जिस तरह हम वॉलीबॉल खेलते जो नेट यूज करते हैं, इस तरह का नेट. नेक्स्ट रिमोट. रिमोट मीन्स फार अवे, यानी कि दूर दराज के जो इलाके होते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड रिमोट एरियाज, राइट. कम ऑन द नेक्स्ट पेज. सलीम अली वॉज इंस्ट्रूमेंटल इन सेविंग द वेटलैंड्स ऑफ भरतपुर एंड हेल्प इट बिकेम अ सेंचुरी. So author says in these lines, Salim Ali was very important to saving the wetland of Bharatpur because it was the sanctuary of the birds. Sanctuary means such a place where foreigner birds come, right? They feel the safe there, safe place for the birds. Next line, the local villagers wanted to drain the marshes and use the land for agriculture. But he raised awareness among the people and the rulers to save this wetland, which was heaven for the migratory birds. This was the place where BNHS began the ringing of birds in India. So in this line, author says that in Bharatpur, there was a place that was wetland. Yani ki aisa jagah thi jahan pe wo daldal hoti hai. So they wanted to like drain that wetlands and they wanted to make that place for agriculture. Means who wanted to make that place for agriculture? Means farmers of Bharatpur. But Salim Ali said that it is the best place for the foreigner birds. So it's a sanctuary for them. So we should not do it. Next line. After India gained independence, he not only took over BNHS, but also saved the institution from shutting down. He was honored with the Padma Shri and the Padma Vibhushan, and in time came to be known as a Birdman of India. He passed away in 1987 at the age of 91. leaving behind us such a legacy of ornithology and bird watching. So in these lines, author says that he saved the wetland of Bharatpur and BNHS also he saved, and he got two awards like Padma Vibhushan and Padma Shri, and he died when he was 91 year old. So he was also called with the name of Birdman of India, right? So this is all about this chapter. Some two more words are there. Let's understand them. Instrumental means important in making something happen. यानी किसी चीज कोई किसी चीज का विशेष होना किसी काम के होने में. Migratory birds, birds that travel from one part of the world to the other during winter. यानी कि ऐसे birds जो किसी एक part से दूसरे part में travel करते हैं winter के दौरान. Right?